There are plenty of warnings about the dangers of being glued to our screens. But what about the chemicals that make those screens light up?
What we're studying are the chemicals.
University of Saskatchewan professor John Giese is a world-renowned toxicologist.
What we decided to do was just smash up a bunch of cell phones and extract them, and then use our technology that we have here in the Toxicology Center to identify all the chemicals.
He identified 360 liquid crystal monomers, the chemicals inside the screens of LCD televisions, smartphones, and even solar panels. About a third of those chemicals are potentially toxic. Next, his team went to China, where devices are often manufactured. They tested dust samples from inside 30 buildings and found those chemicals.
We found very high concentrations in dust. Less so in people's homes, but more so in industrial settings or laboratories.
This environmental scientist says the sample size may be small, but the findings are significant because regulators have been ignoring these chemicals.
Because they're embedded in the screens for devices, the exposures are considered to be relatively low at this point. And that's why Dr. Giese's information is so important, is that now it shows that these exposures are in our homes.
Joanne Fedick is the director of Saskatchewan's Waste Reduction Council. With so many people using these devices and recycling them, she has a lot of questions.
What the chemicals are, in what concentrations, where they found them, how they got there, whether this is something we need to be worried about just yet, how can we protect ourselves?
We don't want people to get alarmed.
Giese doesn't know how chemicals are being released or how toxic they could be. His next step is testing hundreds of dust samples from inside North American homes. Bonnie Allen, CBC News, Regina.